everybody. Welcome to day two of your Party Like a Rockstar training. Today, we're going to be talking about people coaching, formerly known as hostess coaching. So really, really fast. The reason why I'm calling it people coaching is because I want to take that pressure word hostess out of the picture for a little while and just put people in front of it. Because end of the day, remind yourself that these people are people too, okay? You don't have to put so much pressure on yourself on having the exact right words to say at the right time and coming up with the perfect hostess coaching outline. Because end of the day, there's not really a golden script out there to use with your hostess. As long as it's effective and the communication is clear and you are giving her clear instructions that are productive in your party overall that brings results, that is basically the idea. So hopefully that last sentence didn't add any pressure for you. But what I mean is, you'll see in the training later today what I mean by that. But essentially, when you're creating your template, I'm gonna be giving you a free one today, but when you're creating your template, what you really wanna focus on is, are these activities going to help my hostess earn as many rewards as possible in the end? Or is this just kind of a waste of time, right? So think about not putting so much pressure on the hostess either. We don't want to overwhelm her with a bunch of novels. I don't really believe in that. If you have to send somebody a message that's like that long, for me, it's like, it's just too much, right? And if I think it's too much and I don't want to send it, I don't feel comfortable sending it, my hostess is probably just going to look at it and say, whoa, what did I get myself into, right? You don't want to overwhelm them, because then you're just going to create a ghost host. Nobody likes a ghost host, right? You want your hostess to be involved in everything that you're doing, and you want her to be excited about the party. So today, that's what we're going to be talking about, how to create your own templates, right? I totally believe in having a template or some kind of outline available that you can reference off of. Maybe you don't have to copy and paste it every single time with all of your hostesses. And obviously, every hostess is different. So you want to personalize some of it and change some things up per situation, per hostess. But having an overall foundation helps you stay organized and consistent. And that is what we want to learn this week, right? We want to stay organized and consistent in our businesses. And having that in your back pocket is a huge tool for you. And a lot of times, these hostess coaching templates, when you create one for yourself and you're consistent about it, you are going to see those results tenfold. Just because the key to a super successful party, I totally believe, is in the people coaching / hostess coaching. Because when the hostess is involved and she's excited and all her friends are really there to see her, not you, no offense, but that's the reality, then she has the power to drive that excitement into her people. And her people are bought in and she's bought in and you're there along for the ride. A lot of times you can just kind of sit back and your hostess is mostly doing most of the work for you, which doesn't happen all the time, but when it does happen, it's great. So as I mentioned today, that's what we're gonna be talking about. There's gonna be a free template that you can download. You can personalize yourself. If you'd rather create your own, you can do that as well. But just know that there's no golden script out there. There's just not. Some people may swear by the ones that they use, and you can always try it out, but everybody's different. So if you wanna create your own and you wanna be more genuine about the things that you say and how you communicate with your hostess / person, then don't feel like you need to, you know, copy somebody else's stuff. Create your own and also do what's best for you. And sometimes that might take a few different tries on different hostesses to find what fits for you, right? Sometimes you gotta change the instructions a little bit or the way that you say certain things. But that's totally okay, because everybody's different, right? So I hope that you find value in today's training. I hope that it helps you stay a little more organized when it comes to your communication with your hostess. And if you have questions, comment below. I will see y'all later today. Bye.